Joining us now is Bob Proctor, New York Times best-selling author, lecturer, and counselor. He's been described as preaching the gospel of positive thinking and maximizing human potential. What's going on? What do you make of all this?
I think it's a great thing. Listen, I've been in the business, Larry, now for 38 years. I've been studying it for about 47 years. And over the past 25 years, there's been a real spiritual transition, I think, taking place in the world. And I think this is just sort of pushing it off into a new dimension.
Were you surprised that Secrets did so well?
I think everybody's surprised it did so well.
No,
I thought it would do very well.
You couldn't have predicted number one everywhere.
No, you couldn't have. But it was done so well. I think Rhonda Byrne has done a magnificent job putting an idea across that a lot of people have been working with for a long time.
Our tragedies are 9/11 an interruption of the concept?
I don't understand why 9/11 happened, but I do know this, that all down through history, things like that have happened, and we automatically assume that death is a bad thing. Death is a transition. It's much the same as birth, and I think people move on to the next phase of an eternal journey.
Let's get a call for Bob Proctor. Glen Burnie, Maryland, hello.
Hi, how are you?
Hi.
Mr. King, I would like to ask your guest, I guess not so much a question, but how would I go about, I would like to write a book about depression and I was attacked.
I think that's kind of off topic. I'd rather you write in about that rather than the concept of doing a book a little bit off the topic. Maybe I guessed wrong. I'm sorry, but if you'd write to me, I'll put you in touch with the proper person on handling and writing a book. An email question from Donna, Gainesville, Virginia. What can you do if a wife believes and practices the law of attraction, but the husband does not? And if like is supposed to attract like, why do so many marriages involve opposites?
Well, I think people are attracted for all kinds of crazy reasons when they're young. But if one person is focused on the positive and the other one's focused on the negative, you can't see them as being focused on the negative. When people come to me with that, I tell them to write out 10 good things about their spouse and just focus on those. There's positive things in the spouse, too. If you're focused on what the spouse is negative in, you're in a negative vibration yourself.
What if you want to do something, maybe the lady, that you don't have the talent for? What if you want to write a book, but you're not a good writer?
Then you'd probably get help. I wrote a book. I don't think I'm a great writer, but I got help. We train people. We teach people. We have secret symposiums where we get in and teach this to people. See, it's not just the law of attraction. People have to start to understand themselves. Most people don't understand themselves. Inscribed over the Ark of Apollo for the past 2,000 years are two words, know thyself. The average individual on the street thinks they're their name or they're their body. They don't know themselves. We go right through our educational system and learn very little about ourselves.
Define attraction as it applies to the secrets. What is attraction?
Attraction is, it's a law, and you attract things into you. Your brain is an electronic switching station. And when you think, you activate brain cells. And those brain cells set up a vibration. You've got an electrical system in you that's second to none.
It's a scientific fact.
Absolutely. Well, they're measuring brain waves. The brain is an electronic instrument. And our body is an electronic instrument. And we put our body into a vibration, our mind and body. And whatever vibration we're in is going to dictate what we attract. People that are focused on the negative are always going to attract it. You'll find people set goals of getting out of debt. It's the worst thing in the world that a person could do. They should set up an orderly debt repayment program and then focus on prosperity.
What do you do, Bob, with bad days?
Well, I think everybody has bad days. I think you eliminate the bad as quick as you can and get focused on what's good.
Yeah, but that's But
you can train yourself to do it. I used to have all bad days. Now I pretty well have all good days. I have bad parts in them, but I don't focus on the bad. I get rid of it. But I completely changed the way my mind operates. And I did it through education, through studying and going to people. It's taken me 47 years, but it's got better over the 47 years. Like, you know, you were asking earlier, will this, you know, lengthen your life? I'll be 73 on my next birthday. I got more energy than most people, 23. And I've got no intentions of slowing down. I don't even think we have to slow down. I think we should calm down. We should control the vibration we're in. We should be relaxed.
Bob, I thank you so much. It's always good seeing you.
Good to
Bob
be
Proctor, New York Times best-selling author, lecturer, and counselor. He's been described as preaching the gospel of positive thinking, and as you could tell just by being around him, maximizing human potential.